Around the World with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor. We're here at ACTRIMS 2017, and I'm joined here by a good friend of ours, by Dr. Jay Rosenberg, who's staff neurologist at the MS Center, at the Neurology Center in North County, San Diego. We just came out of a session that has to do with imaging and multiple sclerosis, especially focused on how do we standardize imaging, because we want to look at things like environment and genetics, and we want to have a standardization. But they looked at something called cortical atrophy. What is cortical atrophy?
Cortical atrophy is loss of brain substance that can be measured. And what they showed is that it can be measured pretty consistently, and that there are certain areas of the brain that are very, very consistent and are reproducible in their ability to measure cortical atrophy. Another thing that they did is they looked at patients who were at risk for first-degree relatives, meaning they had a parent or a sibling who had MS. Mm-hmm. And they looked at those patients, at those people, and they did MRIs on those people.
Okay.
And from what I gathered, they couldn't consistently show that the MRIs were highly abnormal in those patients who were at risk. But what was interesting is that they did show that if you measured the ability of your perception of vibration from when you put the tuning fork on the foot, that those patients who had decreased vibration had a higher risk for developing MS in that patient population of first-degree relatives.
So what does that mean for you when you're talking to somebody who's the child of somebody with MS, or the parent of someone with MS, or the sibling?
I still think what it means is that the risk of developing MS is still somewhere around 2%.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think that that has changed. I specifically asked that question, and that really hasn't changed, and that the risk is still 2%. Some people say 4%, but I think that the accepted value now is 2% risk of developing MS if you have a first-degree relative.
But another way of saying that is it's 20 times the normal risk if you don't have a family member with MS.
Well, that's another way of saying it. On the other hand, it's also saying it's a very, very low risk in the realm of things.
And one of the things, you know, we used to not be able to tell mothers who were expecting, we used to not be able to tell them anything they can do to reduce the risk of their child, even though the risk is so small. But there was nothing we could do. Now, some people are talking about giving vitamin D during pregnancy.
Well, vitamin D during pregnancy, and I think that vitamin D is very big. Keep once the child is born, you want to try to not overfeed the child so that the child is obese.
Mm-hmm.
Keep, and I think maintain vitamin D is what I got out of this more than anything else.
Well, Dr. Rosenberg, I want to thank you so much for joining us, and I want to thank you for joining us at home.